regulation of the GFR, the neural mechanism. When the blood volume decreases, this leads to the increased renal sympathetic activity, which causes increased renal sympathetic activity as well as the increased circulating catecholamines, which causes a constriction that in turn results in the decreased RBF and the GFR. Next, coming on to the hormonal mechanism, angiotensin 2 acts mainly on the efferent arterioles. Then comes the histamine. Histamine causes the arteriodilation, thereby increases the renal blood flow, but it causes the constriction of the mesangial cells, so leads to the decrease in the GFR. Dopamine is a renal vasodilator. It increases the renal blood flow. It also causes the relaxation of the mesangial cells and increases the GFR. It locally inhibits the renin secretion, and this also contributes to the increase in the GFR. Coming on to the ANP, dilation of the efferent artery, it causes dilation of the efferent arteriole and constriction of the efferent arteriole, considerably increases the GFR. Next is the endothelin. It is a potent vasoconstrictor. It constricts both efferent and the efferent arteriole, thereby decreases the GFR. Next, the nitric oxide is a potent vasodilator. It is also known as the EDRF, the endothelial derived relaxing factor. It causes the vasodilation and dilatation of both afferent and the efferent arteriole. This leads to the profound increase in the GFR. Next, the bradykinin. They stimulate the release of the nitric oxide in the prostaglandins, will lead to the increase in the GFR and the RBF by vasodilation. Next is the adenosine. It causes the constriction of the afferent arteriole and the efferent arteriole, and therefore reduces the GFR. Glucocorticoid increases the RBF and the GFR. Now the prostaglandin increases the RBF by decreasing the vasoconstrictor effect of the catecholamines and the angiotensin 2. PGE2 also causes the relaxation of the mesangial cells. This also contributes to the increase in the GFR. Hypotension and shock conditions, prostaglandin plays an important role in the regulation of the GFR. It causes the renal vasodilation effect, which protects the kidney by opposing the sympathetic constrictor activity and maintaining the renal blood flow even at the times of shock. Coming on to the autoregulatory mechanism, it is maintained, the range in which the GFR is maintained, it is 80 to 180 mmHg. Next, the myogenic theory. The afferent arteriole is stretched and the stretch induced contraction. Afferent arteriole is stretched and stretch induced contraction of the smooth muscle of the afferent arteriole decreases the GFR. Tubulocrimillary feedback. When the GFR is increased and the flow of the fluid in the tubule is increased, this is sensed by the macular denser cells. It sends the signals to the glomerular apparatus that causes the afferent arteriolo-constriction to decrease the GFR and bring back to the normal. This is called as the tubulo-glomerular feedback. Macular denser senses the flow-dependent changes in the NaCl reabsorption. This tubulo-glomerular feedback is also mediated by the adenosine and nitric oxides. The adenosine produces the vasodilation in most of the vascular beds, which causes the constriction of the afferent arteriole.